ladies and gentlemen, from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Hollywood, our next bout is your co-main event. It's brought to you by Seminole Warriors Boxing Promotions, the Seminole Tribe of Florida, and the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Hollywood. This bout is scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing in the light heavyweight division. Your judges scoring this bout at ringside are Rick Bays, John Rupert, and Bill Ray. Your referee in charge of the action, Jorge Ortiz. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the blue trunks. He weighed 174.5 pounds. His professional record, 20 wins, 7 losses, 1 draw, with 5 wins by way of knockout. He comes from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Here is Emmanuel, the Chicano Dream Esparza. His opponent fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black trunks with the red trim. He weighed in 172.75 pounds. His professional record, 30 wins, 3 losses, with 26 wins by way of knockout. El hijo de Barranquilla, Colombia, y Carolina, Puerto Rico. Here is the hard-punching Edison Pantera Miranda.
You gotta look at the popular Miranda.
Come on up, guys. Edison. Okay, guys, we went over the rules in the locker room. I want to remind you, protect yourself at all times. In case of a knockdown, take a neutral corner. Want a clean fight? Touch gloves. Good luck to both of you.
And the tail of the tape. Edison Miranda at 5'10", comes in at 172. Esparza at 174. Esparza, the older of the two, 30 years old.
You ready? Edison, Nito, ready? Timekeeper, let's go.
Here we go, round number one of a scheduled 8-rounder. Comeback fight of sorts for Edison Pantera Miranda, who suffered that knockout in his last bout at the hands of the very talented and underrated Arthur Abraham right here at the Hard Rock Live. That was back in June 21st of 2008. And the hard punch of Miranda looking to lay some leather early on in this fight against the man known as
Miranda. Problem is defense, as you can see, easily hit right there. He caught another little hook on the inside, but he's a strong puncher and he knows how to get you out of there. And you know, you see, you have a strong jab, one of those respect me right now jab, and you know, he's right down the pipe. He's going down right down the pipe. He's just what coming at him. You need to be aware of.
Scored 2 spectacular knockouts right here in South Florida. One against Willie Gibbs in 2006. Just an ice job in the first round, the likes of which was replayed over and over again as one of the great knockouts of the year. And then, of course, here at the Hard Rock Live in January, about a year ago, he knocked David Banks into the third row. And I think Banks is still seeing butterflies from that one punch by Miranda.
Yeah, there's no doubt Miranda can punch. You know, he has some devastating punches. I've seen him hit guys where it is scary, but you know, I just hate to see a guy with so much upside and so much talent don't pay attention to defense. And you end up paying for that in a few big fights that he entered.
Fought Kelly Pavlik for the middleweight championship of the world. Kelly Pavlik ended up winning that fight on a knockout, but that was as competitive a fight as you'll ever see. Both guys blasting away with pulverizing shots. Great riveting action all the way throughout from the opening bell. Esparza gets hammered that time by a right hand from Edison Pantera Miranda. And his face is already significantly reddened as Esparza, as we're 2 minutes into round number one of the scheduled 8 round.
As you can see, Edison is establishing his job. Right there, trying to throw an uppercut. Big right hand.
Look out.
Big hook over the top.
That is a tense winner right there, Glenn.
And that's what he's known for. He's known to throw those big shots and get you out of there.
Well, you just have to wonder if Esparza, who actually had an 8-year layoff before a comeback fight in April of 08, is going to have enough legs to put up with what is going to be a steady onslaught of power punches from Edison Miranda. And Miranda's walking through Esparza.
Oh, definitely. it's a good fight. You know, he's trying to weather the storm, but Edison is a guy that keeps his power for a long time. He's not like his power going to fade in rounds.
So if that was deemed a feeling out process, I think what Esparza was feeling was a little bit of punishment there. No great telling blows, nothing that was going to end the fight. But Edison Moran, as you said, establishing his power early on and establishing his jab a little bit. And once again, looking a little bit vulnerable on defense.
Here you can see the combination between the two guys. Good uppercut by Miranda, and he's throwing the hook. See the hook land right there, and then right there you want to go to the body and soften it up around there. So when you get on the inside like that, you want to go to the body and try to get body shots in.
Smothered Esparza in the first round too. Esparza a little chance to punch back, landed a couple of shots, as you said, with the vulnerable defense, but it was all Miranda in round number one. Here we go, second round of a scheduled eight rounder. Don't know if it's going to go that far based on the evidence we had in the first round. Edison Pantera Miranda on the comeback path after that devastating knockout. He was winning that fight for the first couple of rounds as Abraham went into that little shell, a rope-a-dope of sorts that he uses. And then Abraham was a much stronger puncher than we thought. Landed a shot and knocked Miranda down three times and the fight came to a close in the fourth.
Right here, Miranda is doing good work. He's going to the body. He's keeping his hands up well. He just don't react well when you see punches coming at him. He's keeping his hands up, which is a good thing. But he also needs to move in the right direction away from the punch, which he's not doing. He's moving into the punch when he tried to move his head. Even though his hands is up.
Doing a little hot dogging in here. He's blocking a lot of punches with his face, however. So it seems like an inch. Opportune time to be showing off. He fights mostly out of the Midwest. And as we said, had an eight-year layoff. He's been in there with a couple of big-time Midwest fighters, including Buck Smith, who I think has the all-time record for victories. When he fought Buck Smith, a legendary Midwest fighter, had 179 wins on his resume. Can you imagine? Wow. Twice as many as Sugar Ray Robinson.
Was he a world champion?
And you figured it was only a matter of time. Does not look like he's going to spring up, and if he does, wobbly. Now he appears to be okay, but Miranda with a minute and a half to work him over here in round number two. Well on his way to a knockout victory. Esparza just standing there in front of Pantera Miranda, a very dangerous proposition. Doesn't have any legs beneath him. Doesn't appear to be in the greatest of shape either. And a spaghetti leg right now, and you can make a case for just an immediate stoppage.
But Miranda needs to go to the body. You see, he's headhunting, and right there, good body shots. He needs to start working the body if the guy is not prepared for the body shots, and then he could bring it back to the head.
Huge punch is being landed by Miranda without any defensive effort whatsoever by Esparza. He's throwing nothing back in return. Miranda picking the spots, backs off the punching room right now. Inside of 40 seconds to go here in round number two. A little bit of blood coming from the mouth now of Esparza. And this looks like it's only going to be a matter of time.
Miranda needs to also pay attention to defense. When you're going out there and swinging at somebody who's not punching back, they might just come out and ring something at you. So you got to pay attention to defense while he's in there and go to the body. Get the body working.
Inside of 10 seconds to go, round number two. Looks like his body's going to
survive. No punches.
That Pantera Miranda doing his thing. Maybe part of the reason he wasn't able to finish is because he got a little bit sloppy from a technique standpoint. But you can address this. You know you have it.
No,
you have a tendency maybe to relax a little bit.
that one of the things that happened in the corner there, you can see he's going into a combination, but it's not the Nakagaya.
Oye, está esperando la derecha. Dame la izquierda. Ahí.
He's just covering up and just trying to stay safe.
La voy a poner arriba, después abajo, abajo, y arriba por el medio.
The right shots. You gotta pick the right punches. Go to the body.
Está esperando la derecha.
The body and then open up the head shots. But he's just going directly to the head. The guy just bending over and avoiding the punches. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, man. Joseph right now, it appears to be a showcase for Edison Miranda, a 10-8 round in round two, 10-9 in round number one, and a clear cut. Oh, good. Jolts the head back of his poison. What kept him standing there, Greg Johnson? Well, it's a good hook, but it have a little bit too much distance on it. If it was a shorter hook, it'd have a little more impact. But Miranda need to work the body a little bit more. That would take away some of the movement from Emmanuel as well. So, you know, keep using that jab, get close, and go to the body.
Right.
So as far as I can weigh in, he had a pretty somber look on his face, and you can see why now. He knew he had a tall assignment. The eye beginning to swell up. Might have broken his nose there with that shot. That should be it, you would think.
Four, five,
you could see his nose
six,
almost broken in two.
Seven,
that was a vicious
eight,
inside right
nine,
hand.
That's going to
be a lot of blood running out of his nose.
You don't want Esparza to get up from that. A knockout victory. One-sided fight for Edison Pantera Miranda, and the doctor's going to have to immediately give some attention to Emmanuel Esparza. You hate to see that. You can see that he was vulnerable to some kind of serious injury. There was not enough in the way of action for the referee to necessarily stop the fight. He tagged him right on the nose, and it might have broken. That was a great shot.
It was a good timing punch right on the nose. And immediately as he go down, you see the blood start dripping out his nose. And here you get a look at it. He got his head wrapped up like a headlock. And the referee separate them and step out the way. And he still, boom, right there. Good corner, left hook, right on the money. And here you get another look at it. Boom, right there. Immediately, he went for the nose. Let you know that something is seen to happen. That's a broken nose.
Yeah, that doesn't look good. He was spaghetti legged. His face was starting to look like hamburger meat. And then he catches that left handed wicked shot. Lightning quick speed there from Pantera Miranda. That was the kind of stuff he was doing against Kelly Pavlik. And you were wondering what kept Kelly Pavlik up in that fight. He was able to come back. Of course, we know that Pavlik has an iron chin, much like Antonio Margarito. But that was scary when you saw that shot land right on the nose, right on the bridge of the nose of Emmanuel Esparza.
Well, again, when you see the blood start gushing out the way it was, that's the side part. But, you know, that's that left hook, the quick reaction left hook. I'm in love with it. I love to see when guys use that quick reaction left hook.
I don't feel anything broken.
No, the doctor's telling us that he doesn't think the nose is broken. Let's get the official.
Settle down, ice it down, and we'll check it again later, all right?
We're going to have to blow.
All right, so we're going to get a look at some of the action. Here you go. Knockdown in the second round, Glenn.
Boom. Right hand, right over the top. And then he come back, kind of shove him down a little bit with that hand. And here you take another look at that sweeping left hook that did all that damage to the nose that the doctor is working on it right now, trying to stabilize the blood.
The good news in
this corner. Let's get his gloves off.
You get a look at Pantera Miranda.
Let's get the gloves off in the ice.
Attacking the knockout.
Pedro!
And celebrating with his fans. We're ready for the official time with Bob Alexander.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Hollywood, your referee in charge, Jorge Ortiz, reaches the count of 10 at 52 seconds of the third round. Your winner by knockout, Edison Pantera Miranda.
Does that mean that he's back, Glenn Johnson? That's always the magic question. How does the guy respond from a difficult loss? We've seen Miranda come back from losses before, like the one to Pavlik. This time it was Arthur Abraham who waxed him here at the Hard Rock Line about 7 months ago, and he comes back with maybe a tune-up fight, but looks good in the process.
Well, the one thing that I see is a big difference where he's paying attention to defense and he's keeping his hands up He's not moving his head in the right direction to avoid punches, but at least he's keeping his hands up. And that's a good sign in the right direction. So we see what happens when he step up against another opponent that have a little bit more to offer.
And for Emmanuel Esparza, who was out of the ring for 8 years, we're going to see the tail end of the fight here. And look at that hook.
Sweeping hook coming across, good reaction hook. And again, he's still trying to stabilize that blood, trying to stabilize the nose. It looked like a broken nose to me.
Good job by Edison Miranda. Confidence builder, you'd have to say, Glenn. I don't know if you've been in that situation. Most of your losses came when you get jobbed by the pencil. So the psychological damage was more about the politics of boxing than anything physical.
Yeah, you know, I've been lucky where, you know, I've been blessed with good defense and haven't faced any of those vicious knockouts.